Never in my life have I ever had a Cincinnati three-way in my apartment. Oh, that sounds bad. The buds on the trees are popping. Allergy season is upon us, but you can't stop me from making episodes of Sean's first time eating. This one, kind of a hybrid of something that already rocks. Oh, Cleveland, that's Cleveland. Cincinnati, right? Oh, I see why they didn't.
Ohio, Ohio!
Let's give it up for today's donor, Dakota Mahan. Mahan. I want you to eat my favorite meal. Your favorite meal? Me? Bob Evans mac and cheese you buy from the grocery store, then put skyline chili on top with shredded cheese. Basically, a mac and cheese three-way. Illegal in some states, but on the border of northern Kentucky and southern Ohio, very, very prominent and very, very legal.
Feeling good. It's skyline time.
I should get my personality checked. For those of you who don't follow along daily, I am a big fan of skyline chili. Very prominent, found it in Cincinnati. It has since kind of popped up in other places, very big in Ohio. They have three-way. They have four ways, they have five ways. Basically, it's a tub, a big heaping pile of like just plain spaghetti noodles with their signature skyline chili on top. And then, yeah, shredded cheese would be the three way. You can add onions, you can add beans, you can add things to make the ways, the derogatoriness of the dish, more, because the more people, the greater the order. Dakota's from Northern Kentucky. Easy to go over that bridge and be all up in the Ohio-ness. But this one's so exciting because you can make this at home very easily. Even if you don't have access to Skyline Chili at the grocery store, you can get really any chili and do this. But I haven't had Bob Evans mac and cheese from the grocery store since I was like 8 years old. America's number one mac and cheese with that farm fresh goodness. I loved Bob Evans growing up. It was such a treat. It felt like you were eating down on the farm, just right there, but over, right off the expressway, because mine was right off the expressway, and you could still hear the cars as you were scarfing down your hashy bees.
In the time it takes to read the front page headlines and look over the local news, you could finish the best breakfast deal in town.
They'd serve you a big old cup of burnt coffee, and you'd move on with your day. Normally, you just got done with church.
Our sausage must be the best you've ever tasted. I'll give your money back.
Bob Evans, down to the farm.
Still one of my favorite cooking videos I did was when I made a skyline chili breakfast sandwich with like lasagna noodles on it. Look how liquidy this is when you open the can though. Like just all the residual greasy, liquidy, greasy grease. I can only describe the consistency of this from the can as off-putting, but brown sugary and salty and delicious once it's made. Get a little gentle simmer, heat up our skyline. That sounds like a really bad tagline for a festival that's gonna happen in like a big city. We're gonna absolutely heat up the skyline. Probably an EDM show. The Bob Evans Down on the Farm Mac, which I'm excited for because like normally it's just plain spaghetti noodles for a three-way. So the fact that you're incorporating one, big fat elbow noodles, which are already better for a thing like this, easier to eat. And then also they're already cheesed up. I'm gonna do this in the microwave. 30 for 30 on my microwave. Who would be the director? Michael Bay, because it would blow up.
Those are fighting words. I'm gonna punch him.
Doesn't that look good? Skyline chili, the only canned chili you need to strain.
Very liquidy.
I was debating baking this afterwards. Like, Dakota, I know you didn't write that. I could put the chili in the Bob Evans thing and add cheese on top. It'd be super simple. But I like to make things harder and more complicated and more delicious for myself. So I was thinking of maybe adding it all to, like, maybe my cast iron skillet and then putting that in the oven. I'm just gonna do like 350. All right, this is nice and heated up. Macaroni, you have to stir and put back in there. Also, how sick of a name is Dakota? SeanEly, Dakota Mahan, like better names. Oh, this macaroni is looking soupy, dude. All right, it goes back in for two more minutes. 30.
It's a competitive thing.
Fuck you, allergies. I swear to God, I walked by a tree yesterday with Lionel, and I swear the tree gave me the middle finger. Take that, ginger. You're weak. It's been fun on the Sean's first time eating things, seeing your guys' like homemade concoctions like this. Like there's no world I would ever would have bought Bob Evans macaroni. I would have put Skyline chili on top with shredded cheese. Like there's just no world. Like these little mini DIY casseroles you guys are whipping up. Creative.
Creative? I'm a little boy.
You're a monster.
Please, Mama, take me to Bob Evans.
They probably had the two for two for two for two thing, like two eggs, two bacons, two toasts, pancakes for like $3.99 when I was growing up. Like that was the move.
Bob Evans at breakfast time.
Bob Evans, down on the farm beef.
You won't go hungry at Bob Evans, won't go broke either. Come on in for a breakfast break.
Okay, here's where it gets fun and how Dakota, I'm gonna kind of put my own spin on it. We're gonna peel back our, ow, film. Cause this is cooking. That's an instruction I read today, was peel back film. We're gonna add our macaroni. Oh, that really fogged up the lens, huh? I'm looking up like, what's that cool shot look like? I'm gonna add our Skyline chili. I don't know why I'm using a slotted spoon like this. I wanted to see truly if there was anything hard in it, and it's just so liquidy, dude. These chili cans from Skyline, I'm not gonna lie to you, they're pretty rough, dude. Like, this is just too watery. Like, look at that, there's no solid. If you are what you eat, it looks like I'm eating giardia. Mmm, glad I clicked on this video. That looks so unappetizing. Then we're gonna add shredded cheddar cheese. It needs like breadcrumbs on top too, to give it like a little. I want to find more cheese in the fridge from like another bag, like that was not used. There's like a little bit more. You put this back in the fridge with like a third of an ounce. Oh, here's another bag. It's a good excuse to just empty all the cheese in my refrigerator. Okay, Dakota, hear me out. I'm gonna still honor your, I'm gonna do one half of it with breadcrumbs. So I still wanna do it how you do it, kind of. When you have a YouTube show, you gotta zhuzh it up. So I'm gonna do breadcrumbs on half of this. I'm such a texture guy. We're gonna take this, we're gonna cross our fingers. We're gonna put that right in there. And wait however long until I feel like, I don't know, I don't know time. I also really dig the fact that we won't have to put it into a bowl or a plate. Like we're just gonna eat it right out of the cast iron. That's exciting to me. In the meantime, play a Bob Evans commercial. Why am I holding these like this?
There's lots of restaurants. We'd like you to pick ours. So at Bob Evans, we do it right or we don't do it.
You come in hungry, so our helpings are farm size. We do it right or we don't do it. Some places serve one kind of meal. We give you a choice.
Wow, what a beautiful commercial. Okay, let's take this out. I ended up keeping it in here like closer to like 15, 20 minutes. Damn. Holy sh! Look at that cheese meltage. We've got my favorite gold spoon and my favorite gold fork. Good as gold, my babies, good as gold. I guess we go spoon because they're elbows. It's looking Midwest. It's looking Midwest as hell. Just so casserole-y. And wow. Dakota, I hope you like my little zhuzh it up, my little spin on this. All the flavors that you wanted just in a hot, hot cast iron skillet. The Dakota Mahan three-way. Cheers. That just warmed my soul. I'm not even, whoa. There's something about baking macaroni and cheese. And I didn't even do that great of a job. These aren't the best breadcrumbs. I could have done 1,000 things to make this better. It's still like in the 30s outside. I think it's that extra cheese on top. Dakota, I think that's the move. Like in baking it like that really helped. That was just a winter coat suffocating my heart. In the best way possible. Like just look at those bites. This is just sloppy and Midwesty. I'm gonna be honest, it doesn't look great. It looks kind of like a train wreck. It is so good. The cheesiness from the noodles and the added cheese mixing with that Skyline chili. The baking brought everything together. Wow. I did not think this was gonna be like this hearty and like good. I was worried with how loose and liquidy the cheese from the Bob Evans was and from the Skyline, but baking it kind of thickened it all. It was a thickening agent. Eating right out of the cast iron too is just, it's the move. I'm actually shocked. Wow. I think this is defeating my allergies. Like, I feel better. I'm gonna do some of the breadcrumbs bite, which I've been looking forward to. I did a bunch of the Dakota side. Now it's the Sean side. Left side, Strong's, bad reference. Please don't burn your mouth. Mm-hmm. Oh my God. The Progresso breadcrumbs are like too thin for most foods. It gives it a little bit of texture just to have a little bit of the crisp. Dakota, if you haven't done that yet, I suggest the breadcrumbs. Just get a canister of those at the grocery store. This was a great suggestion. Like, this was a fantastic donation. I just want to throw a couple of these down on my coffee table, set this whole thing in front of me, and just watch Netflix for 3 hours. Like, that will stay warm for 180 minutes. Quiet on set. Am I gonna have to kick you off this production? Looking so good. Truly, it's creamy, salty. The sweetness from the brown sugar in the Skyline comes out. And I'm telling you, like, it's the perfect bite. Think of the best bite you've ever had of, like, the middle part of a casserole, that warmth that just, like, just completely, like, consumes your esophagus. That's what's going on here. All right, I'm done being a food reviewer. I'm just gonna take a few more bites, enjoy this, sign out this video. This was such a fun Tuesday. The weather's gonna start warming up. It's supposed to be, like, 80 on Sunday. But for now, we got winter meals. Did you think I wasn't gonna do it? Look at them bee crumbs. If you guys have any requests you want me to do, hit the Venmo, the Cash App, the PayPal. It's all linked right here on the screen. Send funds in the note, write what you want me to do, like Dakota did, and I will do it here in 2022. I mean, that bite is gonna be a spicy with the hotter Sixer sauce. The best hot sauce in the game. Biased review. All right, last bite. Then I gotta, like, go sit in front of the TV and not be sitting at my oven. You know? Cheers, guys. What a day. Do this at home. I know it sounds insane. Do this. Oh, that rounded it up. Oh! I forgot how this is also sweet. So it combines with the, whoo!
CheddarEly, down on the farm.
Once again, we gotta work on our outro.
Bob Evans, down on the farm.